So, welcome to all of you. As promised, today we will take up one topic in points of topology. And then we will take one more topic which we will discuss very thoroughly, points of topology, because these are very much used in algebraic topology. The first one is our function spaces. Recall that when you have a homotopy from some x cross I to y, then you can think of this as the family of functions from x to y indexed by the interval I. Each function is definitely continuous, therefore, it belongs to the set of continuous functions from x to y. That can be thought of as a subspace of the product of y taken x times. And then you have the product topology. But the product topology is not very good because it corresponds to pointwise convergence. What we need is some kind of uniform convergence. And the correct thing one has to cook up. And that is why different topologies on these function spaces is needed depending upon your requirement. That is why the study of function spaces. The one which is most useful in algebraic topology is called compact open topology. So today I would like to introduce you to that aspect. Later on, we will talk about quotient spaces also. Given two topological spaces, let us denote by y power x the set of all continuous functions from x to y. In point set topology, this notation is used to set of all functions from x to y, namely the product of y taken x times, x many copies of y. Since we are not interested in all functions, we are only interested in continuous functions because x is not an arbitrary indexing set here, but a topological space itself, and we are interested in only continuous functions. We will use this notation, the simplest notation for most used concept. Okay, so there should not be any confusion with this one. So y power x will denote all continuous functions from x to y for us. So now topology on this one is called compact open topology. Okay. So the topology is described by describing a subbase. And subbase consists of these, like inner product notation, bracket KU, okay. All those functions which are continuous from x to y, such that they take the compact set K f of K inside U. Okay, so this should remind you that we are more or less using some kind of continuity and epsilon delta condition, U playing the role of epsilon and K playing the role of this delta neighborhood of whatever. But there is no point reference. This should be for all. So that is why this will become uniform continuity, this with respect to this kind of things, this condition automatically. Okay, uniform continuity on compact subsets. So this is the catch here. F of K is contained inside U, captures the uniform continuity aspect. So these K comma U will form subbase. Just means that I have to take finitely many such sets intersect them and look at all such sets, they will form a base. Thus, the topology on this y power x is now such that any open set is arbitrary union of finite intersections of members k1 u1, k2 u2, and kn un. Ki's are compact and ui's are open. Okay, so this is the topology. So just for a while, okay, whenever it is unclear what topology we are using, we will use this notation compact open for compact open topology. Once we are familiar with this, we will not even mention that. Like we are all the time writing just R with its usual topology. Okay. So let us look at the first position here. This y power x with compact open topology is finer than the product topology. Therefore, it is Hausdorff. Respectively, it's regular. If y is Hausdorff, respectively regular. If y is Hausdorff, y power x is Hausdorff. If anything which is finer than the product topology, then that will be also Hausdorff. When I say just y power x, it is the product topology, right? Y power x with CO is finer, I am claiming. So it will be Hausdorff. Similarly, product of regular space is regular. Then you take the finer topology, CO, it will be also regular. Okay, so I have to see why this is finer than this one. To see that, you see the single point is always compact. Therefore, in this collection here, single point, comma U, these are already there. And what are those? They are the subbasic open sets for the product topology. Therefore, this collection has already more elements in it than the standard subbase topology subspace for the product topology. Oh, singleton X is compact. That's all I'm using. Okay, so the first proposition is very nice. So you also know that there are more open sets, okay, in CO than in product topology. Therefore, convergence here will be stronger. Pointwise convergence may not be a sequence which is pointwise convergence function may not be uniformly convergent. You know that. Whereas, if something is uniformly convergent, then it will be pointwise convergence also. So if some sequence of functions is convergent in this topology, in the ordinary product topology also it will be convergent because this is finer than the product topology. The central result that we want is summed up in one single theorem, three parts of that. The second part is the most important one for us, which is of immediate use. Okay, so let us be done with it, and that is all about function spaces that we are going to discuss. So this is called exponential correspondence. Okay, so here is an important extra hypothesis here, restriction here, namely X is locally compact Hausdorff. Y and Z could be any topology spaces. For simplicity, you can assume Y and Z are also locally compact if you don't remember which one to be locally compact. But assuming Y and Z are locally compact does not help you at all. X must be locally compact and Hausdorff. Okay. So what is it involved here is the evaluation map E, y power x cross x to y. What is this evaluation? Evaluation of f at x. F is a function from x to y. The second slot is x, evaluate it at x. F of x. So this is what is called evaluation map. This will be automatically a continuous function. Okay. In fact, this is continuous even if you take here the product topology. This will be nothing but the projection map to the one of the factors. This x is an element of x, so it is x projection of this map. Okay, since I have put a stronger topology here, okay, automatically this will be also continuous. So this is the way you have to see, but you can directly prove that also. So evaluation map is continuous. All right. Now look at the function g from y to z to y power x. Okay, some function is continuous if and only if you take g cross identity from z cross x to y cross x, y power x cross x. So z cross x you land here with g cross identity and then follow it by identity, follow it by evaluation map. If that composite is continuous, g will be continuous. If g is continuous, the product is continuous, composite is continuous, is easy. So what is important here is, if the composite is continuous, then g is continuous. Okay. So this is the key thing which allowed the classical approach of saying parameterized family and so on. This was formalized here. Okay. So let us see what is the proof of this one. Before that, let us look at the third condition here. This is actually tells you the law of exponentials is valid inside these continuous functions. Just like it is valid for sets. You must be knowing that the cardinality of y power x power z is the same thing as cardinality of y power cardinality of z into cardinality of x product. Okay, this is same thing as a raised to b raised to c is a raised to bc for numbers. Same thing is true for cardinality of when you take these things are all functions, but this is also true now for continuous functions is the beauty here. There is, namely, if z is also locally compact Hausdorff, the xi hypothesis there. Then the function psi from y power x raised to z. What is this one? This is set of all contingent functions from z to y power x, which occurs in statement z here, b here. Okay. That is corresponds to under b, it corresponds to a function from z cross x to y. If that is continuous, it will be continuous, and vice versa. Under this exponential component, psi of g is e composite, g cross identity, which is just like here. So c is actually a consequence of b, but we will have to work out. What happens if this bijection is fine, but this actually homeomorphism is what you have to see. Okay. All right. So let us go through this proof one by one. Huh? So I am writing a full detail of why the function, the evaluation map is continuous. I have given you the idea why it is continuous. Let us write down some full detail here. Given an open set U inside Y, we have to show that E inverse of U is open in y power x cross x. So take a point f naught x naught belonging to E inverse of U. I must produce a basic open set which contains a point f naught x naught and contained inside E power U. Then I am done. So what is the meaning of this belongs to E inverse of U? It implies that f naught is first of all continuous function because it is inside y power x, okay, and f naught of x naught, when you evaluate, it is inside U. E of that is inside U. Okay, now you see, now because we have assumed that x is locally compact, okay, of x, there exists a compact neighborhood K of x naught such that f naught of K is contained inside U. Okay. This means that f naught is inside Ku. Okay, since Ku is an open subset of y power x, we get a neighborhood Ku cross K of the point f naught x naught, and clearly E of K comma U cross K is contained inside U. Okay, so Ku cross K. K is a neighborhood, compact neighborhood. Okay. E of, I have found a neighborhood here and a neighborhood here for x naught is contained inside U. All right. So you have to find a x naught, f naught. You must find a neighborhood cross a neighborhood here, right? That is the product topology from y power x cross x. That's why. So this is clear-cut proof, no hand-waving. Okay. Now, let us go to B. From A, we need to prove only one part because we have already proved E is continuous. E is continuous. Okay. If G is continuous, G cross identity will be continuous. Composing with E will be continuous. So only the converse part you have to prove. Suppose this is continuous, then we have to show that G is continuous. For this, it is enough to show that G inverse of a basic subbasic open set is open whenever, what is subbasic open? K is compact and U is open. If I show inverse image of every subbasic open set is open, then the function is continuous. Okay, so how to show G inverse of Ku is continuous? So take a point here, say Z naught belonging to Z. Let's say G of Z naught is inside Ku. That's the meaning of G inverse of Ku, right? Z naught is in G inverse of Ku means G Z naught is in Ku. Okay, then for every point inside K, what we get is E cross G cross E composite G cross identity of Z naught comma K by definition what? G Z naught comma K E of that, which is G Z naught operating upon K. Remember, G Z naught, G is a map from where? X to Y, right? So G Z naught, sorry, G is a map from Z to Y raised to X. So G Z naught itself is a map from X to Y. So G Z naught of K belongs to this open set. So there exists open sets VK, WK of Z and X because this is a product, right? So a neighborhood here and a neighborhood here respectively such that Z naught is in VK, K is in WK, and E of this product is contained inside U. If a point goes inside this one, a composite is continuous, so the entire function operating on a neighborhood contained inside U. This continuity of E composite G cross identity. Okay. Now we use the fact that K is compact. We can pass on to a finite cover K contains I ring to 1 to n VKI. What I have done for each point K inside K, we have formed a WK. So all these WKs is a cover for K. Therefore, I say there is a finite cover WKI. K is contained inside WKI. So let us call this union as W. Okay. On the other hand, let us take the neighborhood for this Z naught to be intersection of VKI. Then E of G cross identity of this intersection here and union there, that will be concerned inside. Okay. Because once it's intersection, this will be true for every element, no matter where you take the second one, to be in one of them, so it's contained inside. Okay. This implies G of V is contained inside KU, because this W is inside K. The whole W goes inside U. Okay. So G of V will be contained inside KU. Okay. What is the meaning of KU? Every element of GV takes K inside U. But they are taking the whole W inside U. Therefore, they are taking K also inside. Since V is a neighborhood of Z naught, we are done, because we have formed a neighborhood here. G of that is contained inside KU. G started with a G of Z naught contained inside KU and formed a neighborhood now. So this shows that G is continuous. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
The compactness, local compactness of X is used here, huh? Now you see in C, in the statement C, there is local compactness assumption on Z also. You know why? Because in this statement, Z is also going up exponential. It is also superscript. So it's easy to remember, whenever the space goes up here on the superscript, those things must be locally compact. The things at the bottom could be anything. Okay, this is y power x. So if something should work properly, x must be locally compact. This whole thing is raised to z, so z must be locally compact. So z cross x, both of them are locally compact, so product is also locally compact. Okay, so that is why z is also locally compact necessary. Y could still be anything. So I'm telling you a trick to remember, things which go up must be locally compact. All right. So let us prove C. The idea of giving all these proofs is so that you will get familiar with compact open topology. Otherwise, one can just take the statement and go away. Finally, we are going to use only the statements. Okay. From B, it follows that the map, whatever you are writing here, psi, this map, how it is defined? Psi of G is E composite G cross identity. Okay. Whenever G is continuous, you have defined this is continuous. So you don't need the B. But even the inverse is continuous. Okay, whenever this is continuous, it is continuous. That will need the part B. It's well defined and its inverse is also well defined. That is what it is important. Okay, it's well defined and is a bijection. Okay. So for that bijective part, you need part B there. Applying B with y power x raised to z in place of z, and z cross x in place of, this is in, it's not is, in place of x, continuity of psi is the same as continuity of, see, I'm applying B here, E composite psi cross, instead of identity of x, I'm identity of z cross x. So y raised to x cross z to cross z cross x I take to y. Okay, if I show that this is continuous, then it will imply that psi is continuous. So this is where I am using B very strongly. What is this map? This is some lambda here from z to y power x. Z is a point of z, x is a point of x. Okay, so lambda z and x. You take lambda z, it is a function from x to y. You can evaluate it on x. This is lambda z x. By B, it will follow that, you know, if this whole thing is continuous, then this is continuous. But why this is continuous? Continuity of this one is obvious because it is again from B. So this latter map is nothing but, you can think of this as y power x power z cross z bracket. I'm putting the bracket other way around, cross x. So from here, y, where are you coming? Y power x cross x. This is continuous. From here to here, again, another evaluation, which is continuous. Okay. So this is given by lambda z x, lambda z, you are evaluating cross x. So it is like evaluation carried twice. That is why, again from B, again from A, it is continuous. Okay. And from B, this will be continuous. So that proves that the evaluation map is, you know, evaluation map is continuous, therefore psi is continuous. The proof of psi inverse is continuous, exactly similar, actually tautology. Everything is if and only if we can go ahead. Okay, so I will leave it to you as an exercise. You have to spend some time to get familiar with what is going on, playing with these exponentials and so on. So you can check this, that psi inverse is also continuous. Okay. Note that in B, we do not need the local compactness of X to prove that the map G from Z1 to Z1 from continuity of the corresponding map. The local compactness of X is needed in the other way implications because it is needed in part A. One important special case of statement B is the homotopy version, which we will be using all the time. This is the special case when X itself is I. Z cross I to Y, instead of Z cross X to Y. Okay, Z cross I to Y is a homotopy, right? This is continuous if and only if it corresponds to the function a little h. I have put little h here. Remember, I have put little ht. Little ht is where all functions from z to y. So now that family is, whole family is a function from I to y, right? So h itself is a function from z to y raised to y. Ht of z is capital ZT. Okay. So h is a function, h of z is a function from I to y, operating upon t is h. So that is the meaning of this. Okay, this is a very special case. And this goes in the suffix up here. So this must be locally compact, but we have actually it's compact Hausdorff. So of course it is locally compact Hausdorff. Okay, therefore, the joint continuity of this one ensures you that a family like this is a just one single function, continuous function from Z into the function space Y raised to I. set of all map all path is from path is in Y with the compact open topology. Okay, I think we will stop here because the next thing is a different topic, namely quotient spaces, so which we will discuss in the next module.